This UCSD TV program is presented by University of California Television. Like what you learn? Visit our website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter to keep up with the latest programs.
SummerFest 2016 has a particular emphasis on Viennese composers and Viennese tradition. It's a great one, of course. We all know that. For this particular program, I want to deviate slightly away from Vienna, but not too far, but it's still very Germanic in a sense. Richard Strauss and Robert Schumann were never really closely affiliated with Vienna as such. They lived primarily in Germany and thrived there. The thing is, I thought it would be nice to have a different look of what was being composed apart from, you know, Schubert, Brahms, Mozart, Schoenberg, etc. What else was going on around the Germanic-speaking world? Strauss wrote the sextet from Capriccio as a prelude to his last opera named Capriccio. It begins with just six players from the orchestra playing this beautiful work. And it was meant to be part of the plot in that there's a debate going on whether poetry or music is really the form of, I don't know, the great messenger of the arts. So this is a character in the opera having composed this sextet, and they're rehearsing and they're talking about it. Thus was born the sextet. But it's such a beautiful piece. It has become actually better known than the opera itself. So it's a frequent work heard in German music concerts. It's really beautiful.
Thank you.
The third movement is the most beautiful movement I think ever written by Schumann, and it's certainly among the most beautiful movements ever written in the history of music. That cello solo in the beginning is as great as it gets. And Schumann was in love. He was having perhaps the happiest year in his life. He was very prolific. He just kept dashing out symphony after symphony, three string quartets, the piano quintet, and this piano quartet all came out in a very short amount of time. And it was an incredible burst of creativity in his life. And he was newly married to Clara Wieck, and he was happy. And so you could tell in this music, there's this, you know, sort of airborne quality, that effusively optimistic, gorgeous, life-affirming kind of quality, you know, similar to his first symphony. It's one of the, you know, most loved works in the chamber music repertoire, and rightly so.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, SummerFest reaching 30 is quite a milestone because it started off as sort of mom and pop operation. I don't mean mom and pop in the bad sense, but it was just really a galvanized local community that really wanted to have a chamber music festival in their midst. And that's why this festival was born. Heichiro Oyama had a vision about how music should be made. He implemented it and the festival began to grow, began to sprout, began to take root, and it has grown so much since. It's like nurturing a child, you know, a very precocious child. And in that, you, in the end, there's no limitation to its potential for its eventual growth, its development. But the thing is, you've got to be really careful watching every step. Musically, you want to keep enhancing it, you know. So we keep on commissioning new works, we bring new artists in. And so these missions have not changed since the beginning. That's just the great part about this festival. There's an underpinning that, you know, like a tradition that has just kept going. And on the outside, there are all sorts of other, you know, branching out. But deep down, SummerFest is a very unique, you know, community-based, community-centered festival. And of course, we are always trying to make ourselves better known and around the world, you know, outside San Diego area. That endeavor won't stop. The thing is, but our roots are deeply here in San Diego, and I think that's a really a tradition worth upholding.